Hi, good morning, and welcome to Yoga in the Sanctuary. Today at St. Andrew's today. So my name is Sage, and we're just going to begin by doing a little bit of Qigong. So go ahead and get in ready position. You're going to have your legs shoulder width apart, knees slightly bent, pelvis tucked up and in. And we're just going to begin by doing the noodle. So again, this is just relaxation. You want to close your eyes, look at your third eye, take nice big deep breaths in and out of the nose. The noodle's just about letting go. So let your shoulders go, let your jaw go, let your hips go. That don't serve you. Just let them go. Do you have audio? Because I don't see it moving. So next up, again in ready position, knees slightly bent, pelvis tucked in, shoulders relaxed. Imagine you have a string connected to the top of your head going to the heavens. And just elongating the spine, the neck. And we're just going to begin by slightly, slowly just rotating our hips, letting our arms go. Again, knees slightly bent. Most of your weight's on your quads. So this is just warming up the spine. And again, your arms are just following you. Up, your spine warming up, you can go a little faster. Again, we all have our own rhythm. Okay, when you're ready, go ahead and hands into fists, hitting lung and kidney points. Again, these are activating energy meridians. Our kidneys have to do with stress, cortisol levels, so we're just lungs have to do with grief. Don't forget to breathe. Thank you. deep breath. Just take a moment to feel how you feel. Okay, so last week we learned a little new one. This is more just activating different points in the body. So you're going to take your fingertips and you're just going to go right under your rib cage where your liver and spleen are. And you're just going to do a little tapotement. So nice and gentle, just going to be slamming the body. Just trying to, just again, activating liver, spleen. Spleen has to do with transformation and transportation of food. Liver has everything to do with hormones, anger, frustration. Again, just nice and gentle. You can close your eyes, you can look at your third eye, you can take a nice big deep breath. So next up, we're going to do tapotement right under the clavicle. These are lung points as well. Again, nice and gentle. You're not really trying to hurt anything. Lastly is right under the eyes, that little recess. Again, really just nice and gentle this time, right? All your fingertips come together. So this is a stomach meridian here. Again, nice and gentle. Go ahead and put your arms back down. Take a nice big deep breath. Hold on to that breath if you can. Exhaling. Inhale again. And exhale. Okay, so last one in Qigong. We're gonna, again, take a nice big deep breath. Bend your knees. Grabbing as much energy from the earth as you can. Inhaling. Bringing it up over your head, exhaling, and releasing, pouring all that energy on you. Big, deep breath, big bend. Again, this is all at your own pace, all at your own rhythm. Exhaling, pouring, just imagine pouring that energy on you. We all need energy. We all get tapped. Deep breath. Try to feel the weight of that energy pouring it on you, exhaling out. And last time, big deep breath. Go ahead and put your hands on Dantian over your belly button. Close your eyes. Take a big, big breath. Big inhale. Holding. Go ahead and set your intention for the day, for the week. Exhale. Okay, so go ahead and get into easy pose.
That was our little bit of Qigong I like to do beforehand. So we're going to begin today by putting our hands together in prayer pose, pushing our thumbs into our sternum. We're going to chant Om Namo Gurudev Namo 3 times. I like to sing it because it sounds better. I like to think so. So nice big deep breath in, exhale, and inhale to begin. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. You can go ahead and put your hands in Gyan Mudra. Really, that's just your thumbs, your thumb and your forefinger together. And we're just going to begin today by doing a little bit of warm-ups. So let's begin by just turning our head. So inhaling to the left, exhaling to the right. Really just concentrate on your breath, concentrate on the movement, your range of motion. Only doing this for a minute. Back to center, take a nice big deep breath. And go ahead and begin by doing neck rotation. So chin to chest, ear to shoulder, back of head to back of neck, ear to shoulder. Inhaling to the left, exhaling to the right. Again, nice slow and steady. We're just warming up. When you get back to center, switch direction. Thank you. ahead and come back to center, taking a nice big deep breath. If you need to stretch out your legs, now's a good time. You can bring them in front of you, go side to side, up and down. Coming back into easy pose. So we're gonna do spinal twist next. Your hands are over your shoulders, thumbs behind. You really wanna try and have your arms parallel to the ground. Inhaling to the left, exhaling to the right. Again, nice and slow to begin. This opens up heart and lungs. Again, all the breath is through the nose. So. Just doing this for a minute. You can go faster as long as you feel like your spine is warmed up. Back to center, nice big deep breath in. Exhale and open up your arms and lotus and relax. If you need to stretch out your neck, now's a good time. If you have to stretch your legs out, good time to do that too. Your shoulder shrugs our neck, so we're gonna inhale up again, squeezing our shoulders into our ears. Exhale, drop them down again. This is a pretty fast activity. You're gonna warm up your cervical spine, which is all right at your neck. This is a great exercise to do if you work in an office, looking at a computer, drive a car. You can do this anywhere, so. Just 30 seconds left. Feel yourself getting tired? Just squeeze harder. Pull your shoulders up higher. Take a deeper breath. You can do anything for 1 minute. Big deep breath in, hold and squeeze. Hold it, hold that position. Exhale, drop and relax. Again, stretching your neck out. Bring your legs forward in front of you, side to side. All right, so today we are doing a lot of upper body work, so we're just gonna, we're doing shoulder rolls. So shoulder rolls, again, you're gonna really try to get that big shoulder rotation in. So inhaling sort of up, exhaling down, I guess. Or inhaling forward, exhaling back. Again, nice and slow and steady to begin. And we're just really trying to get more range of motion and speed out of this. So you wanna try to imagine bringing your scapula, your together in the back and your shoulders together in the front. Not that I can do that. I go ahead and switch direction, inhaling forward, exhaling back. Breath in, exhale and relax. All right, so spinal plexus next, inhaling forward, exhaling back. You're gonna hold on to your knees and you're really just trying to change the two curvatures of your spine. So imagine your low spine, your upper spine, you're just moving that and innervating all the nadis of your spine. So inhaling forward, exhaling back. Remember, the inhale and the exhale are through the nose. Breath, inhale, stretch forward, exhale, drop and relax. And again, if you need to stretch out your legs in front of you, side to side, up and down, you can. All right, Sufi grinds next. So inhaling to the left, exhaling to the right. Again, nice, slow and steady. We're moving ligaments, tendons, muscles. Exhaling to the right. And go ahead and switch direction. Inhaling to the left. That circle as wide, as big as you can. Back to center. Again, taking a nice big deep breath. Just take a moment to feel how you feel. Even though these are just warm-ups, you've gotten to do a lot of breathing and stretching. Okay, so next up, we're just gonna straddle our legs. As big of a stretch as you really can in the straddle. So you're gonna bring your hands above your head, inhaling up. Exhaling down to the left, inhaling back up to center, exhale down to the right. So we're just doing this for a minute. Inhale up, exhale down. So you should feel this stretch in your thighs. If you can't touch your toe, no biggie. Do the best you can.
stretches our life nerve, which goes from our heel all the way to our sciatic on your hips. Last one, and then come up, big deep breath up, exhale and drop down. Okay, and next up I just want you to do your best to really straddle and stretch, and we're just going to hold this, we're not going to come up and down, so this is about as far as I can go today, so I'm just breathe, just inhaling and exhaling. If you find yourself being able to go further and deeper into the stretch, you can do that, but you'll feel this all throughout the interior part of your leg. Doing all right. Again, try to remember a couple things. Don't go beyond what you can do. This is just a gentle yoga class. So, okay, we're going to get on our hands and knees. This is called cat-cow. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, shoulder width apart. Gonna inhale, pushing the belly down into the ground, looking up into the sky. Exhale, chin to chest, arching the back. Again, inhaling up, exhaling down. Nice and slow and steady just to begin. We're just doing this for a minute. But again, this is stretching our nerve, this is stretching out our spine, so. So go ahead and get into baby pose, putting your bottom onto your heels. You can stretch your arms out in front of you or behind you, head to the side or in the middle, whatever you're most comfortable with. Again, we're just going to stay here for 30 seconds. If you ever have low back pain or any kind of back pain, this is a really great stretch, baby pose. Go ahead and get all the way on your belly. And again, we're just going to go into cobra. So let's start with baby cobra. Your elbows are under your shoulders. Your heels are together. Your hands are flat on the ground. Pushing your hips into the ground. Your head arched up, looking up into the sky. And just, again, take a nice big deep breath.
you can hold this position for a minute. If this isn't a big enough stretch for you, you can go all the way into cobra, which is putting your hands under your shoulders, heels together, pushing your hips into the ground as well. So again, this is stretching our low spine. Okay, so go ahead and tuck your toes under your feet. You can get back into cat-cow if you're more comfortable, and then come up into triangle. Again, triangle is flat feet on the ground. Palms on the ground, and you're really just in an inversion. Now, if you're pregnant, please don't do this. We're just gonna hold this for a minute too. So, just nice, big, deep breath. This really helps to drain the lymph, this just doing this inversion. So, brings blood flow to the head. If you're feeling dizzy or uncomfortable, just get back down on your hands and knees. You should feel this all through your back of your legs. You should feel this in your wrists and your arms. More seconds. Go ahead and walk your hands back towards your feet and up your legs, giving yourself a little bit of structure to stand up. So we're almost done, because of course I'm going to make y'all do frogs, everybody's favorite. So heels together, coming down into a squat, fingertips on the ground, and really you're going to stay on your tippy toes. So your head's up, looking up at the sky. So you're going to exhale and come up your bottom, inhale and come down. So go ahead and just do 13 of these. And when you're all finished, just stand up, just shake it out. So anything that you've been holding on to, just try to let go. Great, so that's the end of our warm-ups. Go ahead and come back into a sitting position. We're gonna do a really short Kriya today. Because I want to have a long relaxation and meditation, because we never seem to get that far in this class. So, of course, so we have 25 minutes. So, okay, so today's Kriya is really easy. It's an easy Kriya called Ego Eradicator. So I'm just going to let you all catch your breath, because I have to catch mine. So take a nice, big, deep breath. Hold on to that breath, exhaling out, and hold the breath out. Inhale again, holding that breath in, exhale out, try holding that breath out. So now we're going to try to do this for 5 seconds. So inhaling in, holding the breath for five. Exhale out, holding the breath out for five. And again, inhale in. Hold the breath in for five. Exhale out. Hold the breath out for five. And one more time. And as you find you practice this, you'll find your mind relax. Find you can control your breath. Let go of the things that aren't serving you. Okay, so today's Kriya is Ego Eradicator. Our arms go up 60 degrees. Our fingertips are into our palms. Our thumbs are straight out. And our elbows are locked. So we're going to do this as well as Breath of Fire. So Breath of Fire is inhaling. Really, it's exhaling. So the exhale is... We're pumping the navel at the same time. If you've never done Breath of Fire before, just do your best. So really don't concentrate on the inhale at all. You're going to do that anyway. Concentrate on the exhale. So imagine that you're, and it's all the breath is in and out of the nose. So imagine that you're just pushing breath out of your nose. So okay, go ahead. Begin. We're going to do this for 3 minutes. So when you find that your arms are getting heavy and tired, you're going to bring them up higher. You're going to make them straighter. You're going to really push your the heels of your palms out into the sky. Just keep going. Okay? Do the best you can. And if you really need to take a break with your arms, lift them up higher. Don't bring them down lower. Okay? You can hold on to them up here better than doing anything else. Go ahead. You've already done 30 seconds. Okay, we're through a minute. Concentrate on that navel, pumping that navel, and you'll find that's actually a lot easier than concentrating on the weight of your arms, which is not really that heavy. Remember, the focus of the breath is the exhale, so really don't worry about inhaling, worry about exhaling. Now, if you feel lightheaded, stop and start again. Just means you're go into hyperventilation. So seconds. You can do this. Pull your arms higher. Big deep breath in, pulling your arms, your thumbs together, touching them together. Big deep breath in, sip in some more breath. Exhale, sweeping your aura, bringing your arms down, and relax. Relax your shoulders, your neck, and go ahead and lay down in Savasana on your back with your palms up. We're gonna do a nice long relaxation today. So, change the music. So, laying down on your back, your palms up. You want to unfurl your brow, relax your jaw, relax your tongue. Relax your temporal lobe, relax your neck, your shoulders, your arms, relax your wrists, your fingertips, relax your chest, your hips, just relax your legs and your knees, your ankles and your toes. Feel yourself getting heavier and deeper into relaxation. Let yourself go, all that nice hard work you've done today. Now it's time to heal. one knee, bringing it up over the other leg, stretching out your hips, arms to the side, big deep stretch. Giving yourself a nice big hug, grabbing your arms around your knees, just rotating around your low spine one way and then the other. And when you're ready, and only then, go ahead and roll up and come back into a sitting position. By doing Savasana, we're actually allowing ourselves to get into the parasympathetic, which is a place of healing. The parasympathetic is not our flight or our fright mode. It's actually the other one, the one that just relaxes our entire body. So anytime you're between a sleep and awake state, in a relaxed state, that is the parasympathetic. The more frequently you do that, the more often you do it, like a nanny nap or a meditation, it's just an opportunity for your body to heal. Okay, so today's meditation is called Healing with the Siddhi Gayatri Mantra. This meditation is about healing. So the mudra for it is our elbows are going to be tucked into our ribs, and our hands are going to be facing up into the sky, our eyes closed, looking at our third eye. The mantra is Ra Ma Da Sa Sa Se So Hung. So we're going to sing that. But every time we say it, I would like you, this is for healing, but it's also for people that are suffering. So imagine that every time we're singing this chant, you're thinking of someone, including yourself, that you want to heal. So someone that you want to not be suffering anymore. There's so much suffering in our world right now that this is a beautiful meditation to do. So let me put the music on. Thank you for being patient, as I am slow today. So Sada's going to just guide us, but I would like you to chant if you're in your home. So again, the mudra is your elbows are really tucked into your rib cage, and your palms are up facing the sky. You're going to do this entire mantra in one breath. So we're going to take a nice big deep breath in. Exhale and inhale to begin. Ra ma da sa sa se so hum. Big deep inhale. Ra ma da sa sa. Da sa sa se
say so hung.
Okay, keep going.
Nama dasa sa say so hung. Rama 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 dasa sa say so hung.
Big deep breath in, holding the mudra. Exhale, shake your hands out. And relax. Just take a moment to feel how you feel. Go ahead and put your hands in prayer pose, pushing your thumb into your sternum to sing Long Time Sunshine. Deep breath in. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on, guide your way on, guide your way. Sat Nam. Sat Nam, everyone. Have a blessed day.